Thanks, Garrett. COVID-19 primarily attacks the lungs, but it can lead to more serious problems such as abnormal heart rhythms. Atrial fibrillation, or AFib, is a type of abnormal rhythm. To explain more about this, we're joined by interventional cardiologist Dr. David Lorenz with Hartford Healthcare Heart and Vascular Institute at St. Vincent's Medical Center. Doctor, welcome.
Thank you.
What could happen to the heart when COVID-19 strikes?
Well, what we're seeing is intense inflammation everywhere, lungs, heart, and about a third of the people that are admitted to the hospital will see the heart muscle get a little weak and quite irritable. And with that irritability comes this irregular heart rhythm, atrial fibrillation.
Can AFib increase someone's risk for a stroke?
Yeah, I mean, AFib's been with us forever, very common illness, and we care about it a lot because there's a small pouch that hangs off the heart that if it goes into that irregular rhythm, blood can pool there, a clot can form, and then unfortunately at times that clot can leave the heart and go to the brain and cause a stroke.
And blood thinners are often prescribed, but not everyone can tolerate them. I understand there's a minimally invasive treatment option. What is that, and explain how it works?
Yeah, well, we've used blood thinners for a very long time, but people will age out of their ability to take them. They'll fall, hit their head, and bleed in their brain, or they'll bleed from their intestinal tract. So for a number of reasons, people can't take the blood thinners. There's a new treatment called the Watchman device that came on in 2015, which the best way to think about it is I go in there through a very minimally invasive procedure through the leg up to the heart and close that pouch. It's like putting a wine cork in a wine bottle.
That's amazing. So how effective is the Watchman?
Watchman is incredibly effective. It's as effective as all the blood thinners we've used for years. I simply take a little device. It looks almost like a ball, but it's almost very malleable and will go in as if you're inserting like that wine cork, close that area off. The body's own tissue heals over it. And then that area is then closed. You can't have a stroke from it, and you don't need to take a blood thinner any longer.
Sounds like it's a game changer for older patients.
It really is. It's made an incredible difference for a lot of patients who have, for whatever reason, hurt themselves on blood thinners that they needed to be on.
All right. Dr. David Lorenz with St. Vincent's Medical Center, thank you so much. Great explanation. We appreciate the show and tell, too.
Thanks.